Welcome to this week's episode of Marketing Uncut. I'm Hanniz, and I'll be speaking about social commerce. So this week, following up from what we have covered last week about how brands are using social commerce during the festivities, this week I'll be talking about how fashion retailers are using social commerce for their online activities. So I'm going to cover a few local brands as well as international brands. Most of them are in the mid to high range, so luxury brands in particular. Yes, the lifestyles have changed, especially during uncertain times like these. People are spending maybe more on essential items rather than things that they want, and not so they are spending more on things that they need rather than things that they want. But the market for the luxury market is still pretty much growing, and they are actually pretty steady from what my friends in the industry say. So there is hope for the fashion retailers, and I'm going to share some things that particular brands have actually practiced so that hopefully your brand can also do something exciting and ensuring that you're not left behind. A commerce retailer which you might be familiar with is Valet. They're a Dutch brand, and what they did to ensure that shoppers still continue shopping with them was to create a surprise bag. So they already have they request for the customers' measurements, tastes, and fashion preferences, and then they tailor made the surprise bags for the customer. So what they do is, once submitted, once the particulars are sent into the shop, a Valet employee would create a tailored surprise bag and deliver it to the customer by bike or by car. So it's a very localized service, which is great. You don't have to always be thinking global all the time. Sometimes the people around you are your best customers and the easiest to reach. So returning the following day to take back any items that the customer might not want. So this is a very localized and personal approach, and it actually helped the fashion retailer to hit almost 100% of its weekly sales average in April 2020. Last year has been challenging, and it's clear that there is great potential in store for fashion brands that are willing to adapt their messaging, creating valuable digital experiences and meeting the needs of the customers. So some local brands that I would want to share about would be Naelofar Fashion Valet, Melinda Ooi. But first we'll go into the luxury brands that are international. So I'll be sharing a video about how Louis Vuitton created an online fashion show in March, and then how Gucci actually created an art experience, a physical art experience, but they actually made it into a virtual experience as well, so that you can experience it in person or virtually, depending on how the lockdowns are in your country, right? And then there's Chanel, of course. Chanel had a fashion show recently. They broadcasted it on their social media. They are also very much product driven. A lot of history they share. They talk with local personalities, French personalities, about interests. For example, about women characters in books. So they have this focus groups that they interview, and it kind of feels personal, but still, they're still selling a dream, right? You're very much, you feel that you want to be in their shoes. The feeling that you get from them is that they are still a bit away from you. You know, they're not like some of the brands that are just talking straight. They're not having conversations with the audience that is watching, but more of conversations with the people that they're interviewing. So it's a different approach.
This season, We've adapted ourselves to these challenging times, and I'm very excited to share this journey with you. First and foremost, I would like to thank everyone who has contributed to bring this presentation to life.
My journey, my perfume, Louis Vuitton.
Je viens juste de découvrir l'exposition et je suis très émue. C'est une mode de Chanel qu'on imagine.
Favori.
William Shakespeare.
Votre poète préféré.
Emily Dickinson et Charles Baudelaire.
Vos héroïnes préférées dans la vie réelle.
Il y en a beaucoup. Christiane Taubira, Mona Chollet et Adèle Haenel. Je pense que ça m'a stimulée et donné envie. Un livre qui m'a aidée à grandir. Et à devenir adulte, c'est King Kong Theory.
Je lisais énormément et d'ailleurs, je me sentais parfois stigmatisée.
Très émouvant.
C'est vraiment...
And then in terms of local brands, you can see that Naelofar is very much in tune with social commerce. They have live videos, which also has the buying option. So you can see that it's so easy for people who are interested to purchase, can purchase on the spot once they view the video.
I'm never gonna be that girl who's living in a Barbie world. Could wake up and make up and play dumb.
Then there's Fashion Valet, where they have live videos as well, and you can actually shop directly from the photographs or videos that they post on their social media page. Melinda Ooi is rocking it. Her visuals are always very striking, and she makes it also very easy to shop, but she does not have live videos. Her posts are more sharing background stories, and she attempts to engage with her audience. Her audience, though, is a bit shy. You can see they don't really comment much, but I'm sure they love her clothes and accessories. Then there's Jovian. Jovian is a shop which is very has a variety of things. So besides clothing, they're also now selling face masks. And for the Muslims, they have a special loop so that you don't have to worry about finding your ears underneath the scarf. And then it's actually less painful for the ears. And they're also collaborating with hotels to create a thermal bag, which is great. So hotels, I'm sure that you've been hard hit. This is a way to also work with fashion designers or other collaborations to get your food products out or whatever service that you already have in-house to go externally. And Ala Bastamam, as you can see, she uses a lot more on influencer marketing. She uses user-generated posts, doesn't really sell on their social media page, but rather more of just product features, like a catalog. Valet has multiple brands under their group, so they have created separate video channels where you can watch product features, so not so much interaction, but just like a catalog. There's no buying option at the moment, so if you like what you see, you have to go to the boutique and buy it, or perhaps call them up. Bonia is, they sell accessories. You can see that their shop has options for you to buy through their photos as well as their videos. And so so these are the different things that you can see some of the brands are doing, which is great, which is encouraging, because you don't want to lose your customers when they're already at your page. You want them to buy immediately. The only difference is that the local brands, I feel that they're still a bit shy to talk directly to their customers. Even the international brands, the global brands, I think they are very they prefer things to be staged properly before launching something. So you don't have the spontaneity, you know what I mean. They're not as spontaneous as they can be if they want to, especially when you have a captured audience already. You can see the number of views when you post live videos. I mentioned this last week as well. You get more views outside of your fan base, and you should take the opportunity to engage more with your customers, talk to them. Some brands have engaged models to model the product. So this is a time for the model to also speak and have a personality and ask questions, and ask the audience to ask questions. So it's more of a two-way conversation. This is something which is possible with live videos. And I'm going to share a case study. This is what Adidas did to create a more exciting option for their customers. So what they did was they had a pop-up experience. So the goal of the pop-up retail is to actually create buzz and to accelerate product uptake, right? So experiential events around new product introductions, often piggybacking on bigger events such as music festivals, award ceremonies, and sporting events are possible. But okay, we understand that physical events now are not so happening, obviously because of the lockdowns and whatnot. But pop-up events are still possible when you can, when you're able to control the crowd. So what you can do, like Adidas, what they did was they launched Ransom and Blue design collections with 6 temporary pop-up shops in secret locations. So this was across Germany, Austria, and Switzerland. So they only communicated their whereabouts on their social media page, their Facebook page. So only their Facebook fans would know about it, not their in-store friends. So they actually got people to like more of it, more likes on their page. So each store was designed to pop up in unexpected locations for a few days or a few weeks and sell only limited edition range of new gear, and then they disappeared. So it created a lot of self-funding buzz and a product adoption. It only required a few hours and a single hex key to set up the unique pop-up experience. So if pop-up experiential retail makes sense to you if pop-up experiential retail makes sense in the world of brick and mortar, it should make even more sense online. So the social commerce opportunity here would be to set up online pop-up stores to promote product launches. This is particularly true for e-commerce websites which are run globally. So for example, Chanel is not able to cater to all their boutiques. So you know, you can't have a live event in one boutique and sell everything on the global website, because it's not available for all customers globally. So what you could do is a separate site just for your pop-up events, you know, and you can just have this live show within that pop-up website, which is super cool. And Antas Solutions has that solution where you can have your own live show and it will cross-sell those special products that you want to feature. And the chats that come in are, you can immediately respond to the chats, which is great. You can answer questions from the crowd. And when during the playback, for those who just come on board and they just want to ask questions, they can look for the questions in the chat box. When they click on the chat box, that particular question, it will automatically go to the segment of the playback video where the host answers the question. So is that cool or is that cool? So some of the brands that I hope would be, you know, more forward thinking would be those in the luxury brands who you feel that are tied by red tape and rules and regulations. Pop-up sites might help. And some of the things that, some of the tips that I would like to share with you before I end today's session would be using social media to stream and share experiences that you might have done physically before, and monetize it possibly with an event store, so an e-commerce site where you can sell products already immediately, or a virtual entrance fee. If you're advertising, you could actually reveal your new campaign in social media first, like I recommended last week, and monetize the merchandise that are featured in the campaign. Also look at the bigger picture. Some of the festivals that are not currently going on because of pandemic constraints, you could actually have an online experiential pop-up store in social media around a calendar event that's popular with your fans, or as a holiday or a sporting event or a festival. And consider how you might want to surprise your fans with a special fan event in social media, selling limited edition goods that are only available on social media, on your website. And obviously, if you have a good circle of influencers and celebrities already using or wearing your brand, this would be their time to actually speak on your behalf, rather than the constraints that you might have faced during print media, where it's only the face and not the voice. No, now you can add a voice to the influencers to talk to the fans, to talk to your fans, to talk to their fans. So it's the two different groups that you are reaching out to. So I hope that you have benefited from this week's Marketing Uncut. And do leave your comments below. If you like these videos, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel as usual. Thank you and have a great weekend. See you next week.